In the chapter, we have to see one topic. That topic is known as stationary wave. What is stationary wave? When the two waves having same frequency and amplitude and wavelength, they are mutually traveling opposite to each other and get superimposed. After getting superimposed, they lose the property of the propagation, and stationary pattern is created in the medium. Such stationary pattern in this medium is called stationary wave. Now here we have to obtain this stationary wave in, when the string of length capital L is tied at both the end, and the harmonic wave is produced on one end, then this is travels in the positive direction and they are getting reflected back to other end, that will be traveling in the negative x direction. So both the waves are mutually traveling opposite direction and get superimposed, and finally we get the stationary pattern in the medium. And they lose the property of the propagation. So they form a stationary structure in the medium. They never travels in the direction positive left and right side, any side of this. They are only oscillating there. The particles of this medium waves are oscillating on their mean position. Second point is that here we have to get the equation of the stationary wave, and through this we have to get the equation of the node and antinode, and finally we can get the normal mode of vibration, and we have to get the number of loop is found when there will be n1 or n2. This way we have to get the if the first harmonic, second harmonic and n harmonic, and if f is equal to fn, if that is a nth harmonic, fn minus 1, that is known as overtone. Now we have to get here, that is, we have to get, suppose the waves here, it is traveling in this direction. This is of length x is equal to 0 to x is equal to L, and traveling this, so this is positive x direction, and this is what, negative x direction. So we can get equation here, that is a y1 xt is equal to a sine kx minus omega t, that is a positive x direction, and similarly y2xt is equal to a sine kx plus omega t, that is negative x direction. Now getting superimposed according to the principle of superposition. Principle of superposition, we have got here y xt is equal to y1 xt plus y2 xt. Keeping all this value here, we get here y xt is equal to a sine kx minus omega t plus a sine kx plus omega t. Now solving this way, to get here 2a sin kx and cos minus omega t. Now we know that here cos minus omega t is equal to plus cos omega t. Keeping this value here, we write here, that is y xt is equal to 2a sin kx cos omega t. Now we can use here sin a plus b plus sin a minus b is equal to 2 sin a and cos b, using this formula. Now we can say that this is the equation for the stationary wave. The equation for stationary wave, and f k minus omega t. So this equation y is equal to 2a sin kx cos omega t, this is the equation for the stationary, because the function of this sine function, that is equal to omega, that is kx minus omega t, is not in the form. So directly we can get here 2a sin kx and cos omega t. So this equation is not a function of f into kx minus omega t. So we can say that this equation is about stationary wave. Now after getting the equation of stationary wave, now to get the here We know that the displacement of the particle is always zero at a certain point, and this point is known as nodal point or node. So the displacement here, we can say that the particle which oscillate in this stationary wave as the term of cos omega t, and the amplitude depends upon 2a sin kx, which term is sin kx. So sin kx sometime will be zero, that is known as what, node point, and the sin kx is always maximum. So that is known as empty node point. So first we will write here node point. So node, we can write here node. So we can write here sin kx is equal to 0. Therefore kx is equal to n pi, and therefore kx is equal to n pi upon k. Now we know that here k is equal to 2 pi by lambda. So keeping this value here, so we can get here x is equal to n pi upon 2 pi into lambda, pi will be cancelled, is equal to n lambda by 2. Now we have where n is equal to 0, which is 0, 1, 2, dash. Now keeping all this value, we can get here x is equal to first 1, that is will be 0, means 0, then second is 1, means lambda by 2, then that is 2, means lambda, then 3 lambda by 2. So all these points, the amplitude of the particle is always zero. So this point is called node point. Second one is that amplitude is always maximum, means sin kx is equal to 1. So that is known as anti-node. We can say that this will be always positive, it means 1. So we can write here n is equal to 1. Therefore kx is equal to 2n plus 1 pi by 2. Now x is equal to 2n plus 1, that is pi by 2 into k. K, we know that k is equal to 2 pi by lambda. Keeping this value, therefore x is equal to 2n plus 1, that is pi by 2. K means here 2 pi by lambda. So pi by will be cancelled. So x is equal to 2n plus 1 lambda by 4. Where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, that is. Now keeping n is equal to 0 here, n is equal to 0 means we can get x as a point is lambda by 4. Then second is here n is equal to 1 means we can get 3 lambda by 4. Then we have to put 2 in, that is 5 lambda by 4. So these all these points the amplitude of the particles is, which are taking part in the stationary wave are always maximum. So these points are known as anti nodes. Now second point is that we have to explain here the normal mode of vibration. So first we have to get here, we know that here we can see here the displacement of the particle is always zero at these two points, x is equal to 0 and x is equal to l. Then the displacement is always zero, means we can say that sin kx is equal to 0, therefore kx is equal to n pi. Now we know that here k is equal to 2 pi by lambda into x is equal to here it is a sin kx is equal to 0 or sin kl is equal to 0, therefore kl is equal to n pi. Keeping this all value, we have to get here that is a k is 2 pi by lambda into l is equal to n pi. Pi will be cancelled, so finally we can get here 2l upon n is equal to lambda. Second point is that we have to get here lambda. We know that velocity v is equal to f into lambda, therefore lambda is equal to v upon f. So keeping this value here, so 2l upon n is equal to v upon f. So finally we can get here fn is equal to nv upon 2l. So here finally we can get here fn is equal to nv upon 2l. This is known as what, here the particles which are taking part in the stationary wave oscillate with the natural frequency, and this type of system is called normal mode of vibration. This is known as normal mode of vibration. So normal mode of vibration. Now we know that here, suppose here f, n is equal to here, n is equal to 1. L is equal to, we have got here f1 is equal to v upon 2l. So this is known as fundamental. Fundamental frequency. If n is equal to 2, we can write here. So we can write f2 is equal to v upon l is equal to twice into f1. Similarly, we can write fn is equal to n into f1. So this way we need to get here. So that is known as fundamental frequency, or it is also known as the first harmonic. Then n is equal to 2 means second harmonic, n is equal to 3 means third harmonic. Fn is equal to n into f1, that is known as n harmonic. Now if n is equal to 1, then we have to get here the shape of this first harmonic is like this way, this is the antinode. If I, is equal to n is equal to 1, this is my first harmonic. Now second point is that we have to get here for n is equal to 2, so we can get antinode, n is equal to, that is my set. This is first harmonic and it is second harmonic. Now we have to put here n is equal to 3 dash 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 dash. Suppose n is equal to, here we can write the third harmonic. So this way we have to get here. This is the third harmonic. We can write here third harmonic. So that is antinode, node, and antinode. So this way we have to get here. This way we have to get, this is n is equal to 3 means third harmonic. N is equal to 4, we have to get 4 loops. So if first harmonic is one loop, then second harmonic is two loop, third harmonic is third loop, three loops, and similarly if there are n harmonic, there are n loops are there. So this way we to get the complete information about complete theory of the stationary wave. First I have to give the definition here. When the two waves having same amplitude, frequency and wavelength, they are mutually traveling opposite direction in a medium. Now after getting, they are propagating the, both are having same amplitude, same frequency and same wavelength, both are moving mutually opposite direction in a medium, and they are get superimposed on each other. After getting superimposed, they lose the property of, according to the principle of the superposition, they lose the property of the propagation, and finally stationary pattern is created in the medium. And this stationary pattern or this stationary structure in the medium is called stationary wave. So this way we get the information of the stationary wave. This stationary wave is also used for this guitar or sitar and other musical instrument which are based on the we can say that the first harmonic or overtone, this type of phenomena. Thank you very much.